Hi, I'm Norman Walberger. In the last few videos, we've been talking about polynumbers and associated polynomials. Today, we're going to continue in that vein and talk about the factor theorem that goes back to Descartes. This is a pretty standard material found in most high school courses, and there's nothing very much contentious about it. The reason I'm going in this direction now is because ahead of us there is a very big obstacle, a very big logical foundational obstacle having to do with polynomials. And we want to get to that point where we can address that problem, and it's called the fundamental theorem of algebra. That's where we're headed. Okay, so we're going to introduce a little bit of extra notation today, maybe simplify things a little bit. So the setup is that we've already introduced a very special polynumber, the number called alpha, which is the polynumber 0, 1. And alpha squared looks like this. It's the polynumber 0, 0, 1. And alpha cubed is 0, 0, 0, 1. And it obviously carries on in that fashion. And using polynumber multiplication, the power alpha to the n times the power alpha to the m is the power alpha to the n plus m. Because if you have n zeros and you multiply with the one with m zeros, then the way we've defined multiplication, you get the one with n plus m zeros. All right, so now we're going to introduce a connection between polynumbers and ordinary integers. So here is a polynumber p with coefficients a0, a1, up to ak. These are all integers because we're working in the framework today of integral polynumbers. Here is the standard alpha form for that same polynumber, where we write it in terms of the powers of alpha. A0 times alpha to the 0 plus A1 alpha to the 1 plus all the way up to AK times alpha to the K. And we're going to introduce a new terminology for this expression, just a new way of writing it, nothing else. We're going to say this is P bracket alpha bracket. And we're going to say P of alpha. It just means that we're talking about the standard alpha form of the polynumber P. And now suppose that we have an integer, C. We're going to define what do we mean by P of C. In other words, P bracket C bracket. It is by definition this integer. What you get when you take the standard alpha form and simply replace all the alphas with c's. So a0 times c to the 0, that's just 1, so that's just a0, plus a1 times c, plus a2 times c squared, and so on up to a sub k times c to the k. These are all integers, so this combination is also an integer. That's what we mean by p of c. And we call this evaluating p at C. So for example, if P is the polynumber 2, minus 3, 0, 1, and C is the integer 4, then P of C is 2 minus 3 times 4 plus 0 times 4 squared, which I don't write, plus 1 times 4 cubed, altogether 54. All right, there's one very easy property of this evaluation, that if you take two polynumbers and evaluate at C, P plus Q evaluated at C, that's P of C plus Q of C. And another slightly more complicated aspect of it is that this also works for multiplication. If we have two polynumbers P and Q and our integer C, then PQ of C is P of C times Q of C. In other words, the multiplicative structure with the alphas and with the C's is exactly the same. And it's because, basically, of this property of multiplication of powers of C. C to the N times C to the M equals C to the N plus M. And that's exactly the same property that's satisfied in the polynumber context with the powers of alpha. So if we replace the alphas with the C's, then the multiplicative structure is maintained. So for example, here is one polynumber p, 2 alpha to the 0 minus 3 alpha 1 plus alpha squared, and q is alpha to the 0 minus 5 alpha to the 1, and c is 4. Then pq of c is what? Well, there's the product of this integral polynumber with this integral polynumber in standard alpha form. Evaluating at 4, so replacing all the alphas with 4s, and evaluating gives a minus 114. On the other hand, if we just evaluate p by itself at 4 and multiply by q by itself at 4, then we also get minus 114. Now, at some point, it's going to become annoying for us to always have to write alpha to the 0 plus alpha to the 1, and so on. And so I'm going to take the liberty now of dropping that rather rigid requirement. If we are forced to justify ourselves formally, then we'll go back to this definition. But in practice, we'll just forget the alpha to the 0 and write 2, and we'll forget the alpha to the 1 and just write alpha. Now let's look at the factor theorem, which goes back to Descartes. The theorem says that if p is an integral polynumber and c is an integer, then the polynumber p of alpha minus p of c, where we think of this as a polynumber, has the factor alpha minus c, where this is also a polynumber. Let's have a look at the proof. So here's our polynumber p. P of alpha is written in standard alpha form, but in our somewhat relaxed notation now, as a0 plus a1 alpha plus a2 alpha squared up to a sub k alpha to the k. And if we evaluate p at c, we get the corresponding expression with alphas replaced by the integer c. Now I have to remind you of some identities that we've seen in a number of different times. The simplest one is the difference of squares. Alpha squared minus c squared equals alpha minus c times alpha plus c. Slightly going up, alpha cubed minus c cubed is alpha minus c times alpha squared plus alpha c plus c squared. And there's a whole family of such. The kth one being alpha to the k minus c to the k is alpha minus c times this expression. So decreasing powers of alpha, increasing powers of c. And we're going to apply it immediately to prove the theorem, because we're just going to take the difference between this line and this line, so p alpha minus p of c, which is what we were interested in. And in each of these terms, one over the other, we're going to take the difference, and we're going to see that there's a factor of alpha minus c in each of those terms. a0 minus a0 is 0. This one minus this one gives us a1 times alpha minus c. This term minus this term is a common factor of a2. And then it's alpha squared minus c squared, which according to this has a factor alpha minus c. The other factor is alpha plus c. All the way up to the kth one, which has a sub k times the difference here, which according to this is alpha minus c times this expression. So we plop that into there. And in particular, this polynumber is divisible by this polynumber. And in fact, we get a little bit of extra bonus. We in fact can actually write down exactly what the other factor is. And a very important special case now. If p of c happens to be equal to 0, in other words, if c is a 0 of the polynumber p, well then, this term is 0. So then alpha minus c divides p of alpha, the original polynumber p. So this is the very important connection between the zeros of a polynumber and linear factors of the polynumber. It's going to be a major theme for us. So to move again towards this fundamental theorem of algebra, let's next time look at the division algorithm for polynumbers. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wahlberger. Thanks for listening.